So David Jagodzins of Poland coming to the ring first in the light flyweight division. He's a 21-year-old. So far, his joy in the WSB has been pretty poor. He's had two bouts and lost the pair. Ranked number 20. Another interesting fact about the Cuban side, they've actually fielding four southpaws here tonight. Southpaws can be notoriously hard to box for some people, others not. So there you are then, Jagodzinski of Poland, our first man in the ring. He's a light flyweight, of course. We are, of course, in Havana in Cuba, which is in the northwest of Cuba, for those that don't know. And it's south of the city, this venue, the Ciudad Deportiva. And some 14,000 spectators are expected.
En la esquina de los domadores de Cuba, Yosvani Beitia.
So, Yosvani Beitia, 21 years of age as well. Now, he's had three bouts under the WSB rules and won each one of them. Former World Championship bronze medalist and ranked number one in this tournament. Up against the number 20 in the tournament. Now, the interesting thing about Vitia, all three bouts he's had have been all points wins. He is a southpaw. And one thing we've seen about the Poles as this tournament's gone on, they are tough guys and they've been a bit unfortunate on occasion. So Yosvani Beitia, the 21-year-old Cuban light flyweight. Chief coach, by the way, is one Rolando Acebal, who has trained, amongst others, in the past, the likes of Yuriorkis Gamboa, Joel Casamayor, and Rogelio Garcia.
Primer combate de la noche, división 49 kilogramos. En la esquina de Usares de Polonia, David Sebastian.
So there's Jagodzinski.
De domadores de Cuba, Yosvani Beitia.
And of course, Beitia on the other side of the ring. Now, five judges here, you may remember. And any three of the five will be selected by computer to render their score. They won't know they've been picked. So a referee then gives his final instructions to both lads. And Jagodzinski has got an inch or so here in height advantage, I suspect. That said, you know, Beitia is not a small man by any means. So the Colombian referee gets this one underway. And you can tell straight away, by the way, whether an opponent can deal with the southpaw. And, well, the case here, sadly, for Jagodzinski is, you know, you need to go to your own left against the southpaw, not to your right, because you move on to their stronger hand. And he did start off going to his own right. And, you know, sometimes they have a natural bias one way or the other, and there's not a lot you can do about that. But these Cubans are incredibly talented. They top the group, Group B, with 18 points. The Poles, sadly, with only 1 point in sixth place. And if the Cubans do not win this on home soil, this would be a major upset. So Beitia, they're looking for his fourth straight win. Under the WSB rules here. And he's a very smart operator. And if you're wondering what the Cuba Domadores means, or the Domadores at least, it means that essentially it means lion tamers. So, you know, that's what their job has been, really. They've set out to tame every single team they've taken on. And so far, they've succeeded with only two losses in their entire program. They incidentally were two individual losses, not team losses by any means. They still won the matches, but lost two individual bouts. The Cubans are, without a doubt, the best individual and team boxers on the planet. So, Yosbani Vaita, Vaitia, my apologies, boxing pretty well now. There were a few promising moments for Jagodzinski in the early moments, but since then it's been all Vaitia. Vaitia, very mobile, can punch from any angle with either hand. And of course, a great pleasure to be boxing yet again on home soil. And there's the first round, which clearly, in my opinion, goes Vaitia's way, but we wait for the judges. So a bit of replay from the opening round. Well, there you are, pretty clear. Vaitia won the first round by a single point margin on all three judges' scorecards. So we are, of course, in round two. I just remind you that David Jagodzinski in the black and red shorts up against this very smart Cuban in the light flyweight division, Yosbani Vaitia. And Vaitia took the opener. Well, nice little right there from Jagodzinski. So don't forget Jagodzinski, very, very experienced boxer, bronze in the World Championships. And ordinarily, of course, when a Cuban gets that far, they tend to turn bronze into gold. But sadly for Vaitia, that wasn't the case. He's a very cool operator, isn't he, Vaitia? And Jagodzinski has his moments early on in the rounds, but then Vaitia seems to work him out. It's almost like Vaitia was holding his hands around his face there, saying, go on then, have a go, let's see what you can do. Well, And nothing of any great note, really, from Jagodzinski that's really making a major difference here. And don't forget, of course, he does come into this match with two previous defeats under his belt and three previous wins for Vitia. So a massive difference in ability and, of course, fortunes. And, of course, Jagodzinski wants to turn at least one of these bouts into a win. And the funny thing is, he's not that bad. Well, bit of reddening around the face there now of Jagodzinski. Trickle of blood coming from the nose. And Vitia is not a powerful puncher by any means. And that's about his only drawback, but he's pretty decent in everything else he does. He can, on the downside, just be a little bit casual at times. But no doubt whatsoever, looks like he's won round two as well. And worth telling you that the former form of Cuba include these. They beat Mexico 5-0 in Mexico. This is, of course, a return match between Poland and Cuba. And Poland were beaten 5-0 in Poland by the Cubans. Russia also went down 5-0. Kazakhstan held the Cubans to a 3-2. Cuba still, of course, won that, as indeed they did against Azerbaijan, 3-2. As for Poland, well, they lost 5-0 in Russia, they lost 5-0 in Cuba, they lost 5-0 in Azerbaijan, they lost 5-0 in Mexico, they lost 4-1 in Kazakhstan and 3-2 in Russia. And there's the judges' scores yet again. One judge, interestingly, they had it 10-8. I'm very surprised that was a two-point round for one judge. But at least the other two got it right. So 2018 lead on my card anyway in favour of Vitia. Round three of a scheduled five. Don't forget, all bouts scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds. And the funny thing is that Vitia, despite having won three, he's never had an easy night's work. You know, he's had to work hard to pick up those wins. And let's face it, everybody wants to do well against a Cuban. So they might just bring out that extra bit of percentage. Once again, Vitia, they're taking those shots on the glove. And it really is not an envious position that the Poles find themselves in, really, is it? Having lost 5-0 already to these opponents, you know, that was at home. So the crowd now thoroughly on the side here of Vitia. So two talented 21-year-olds, I'd say. Incidentally, in case I didn't mention it earlier, Yosbany Vitia is one of the number ones that the Cubans have fielded here this evening. And the more of a lion, I think, that Jagodzinski becomes, the more of a tamer Vitia will turn into. And once again, sign there, see, of the casualness of Vitia. He does some daft things every now and then. But by and large, he's pretty talented, isn't he? Don't forget, you can have your say about the World Series of Boxing on the social networking sites around, I suspect, there for Vitia. Although I've got to say also, decent bit of work, at times anyway, from Jagodzinski. Decent right down the replay from Jagodzinski, but by and large, once again, good moments for Vitia. And once again, there one of our judges scored a two-point round in favour of Vitia. Very strange. You're going to get a two-point round generally if you absolutely win out of sight and possibly drop your opponent as well. And you're not blind, you can see that he's not been dropped in this or in the previous couple of rounds, and yet one judge has scored by a two-point margin. I'll leave it there. Round four, penultimate session here. And the other thing I've noticed about Vitia, he actually takes a pretty good whack as well. Once again, you know, this Polish boxer is a very determined, tough young fella. Well, Vitia stalking forward here, avoiding a lot of shots coming his way and managing to counter nicely. And I suspect this casualness of Vitia may cost him pretty dearly, you know, down the line. You never can tell. Now, these are the group stages, of course, and the knockout matches will come. So he's going to have to tighten up as this tournament goes on. And there's no doubt that Jagodzinski's had his moments in this particular bout, but sadly for him, just not quite enough of them. Yes, you can see the talent here of Vitia oozing out of him, isn't it? And he knows he lacks power, and so doesn't go looking for the stoppage or the knockout. And there's the bell to end the fourth. Another big round, I suspect, for Vitia. any right-minded boxing judge would have this 40-36 at the moment, 4 rounds to nil, with one to play. And the only hope now that Jagodzinski's got is to score a knockout blow. Will he? Can he? Well, here we go then for the fifth and final round. And that's fascinating that all three judges in fact scored that contest, that round, by a 2-point margin, 10-8, very, very odd. Yeah, he wasn't that overwhelmingly brilliant against Jagodzinski, and of course he didn't put him over. He won the round. So we are, of course, in the fifth and final round. And this by no means a decider. But Jagodzinski needs to find a huge punch if he's going to make a dent here at all. Well, you could almost say that Vaitia was pretty much coasting in this last round, couldn't you? So this will be the first point on the board for the Cuba Domodores. Oh, that's a slip there from Vaitia. So Vaitia then just seeing this one through, ensuring he doesn't get tagged. And Jagodzinski has tried exceptionally hard, but you know, it really is a task that's been beyond him from the first bell. The judges have given Vaitia a pretty handsome lead anyway, so nothing to worry about here. And there, the final bell coming up now. There it is. Yeah, cracking start for the Cuba Domodores. So a bit of replay coming up for the final round here. And a competent performance from Yosbani Vaitia. Looks like he's picked up his fourth straight win.
Resultado del combate. Juez uno.
So here we go then for the official verdict.
Resultado del combate. Juez 1, 50-42. Juez 2, 50-44. Juez 3, 50-44. El vencedor, por votación unánime, de los domadores de Cuba, Yosvani Beitia.
Yeah, very comprehensive 5-0 win there for Yosvani Beitia over, of course, David Jagodzinski of Poland. So a great start then for Cuba. And let's just see then if Kozlowski of Poland can make a dent in Forestal. That's a bantamweight contest and it's coming next. And for those of you interested, by the way, in the group rankings, Group B, obviously, you know, I said this before, that Cuba in top spot, Kazakhstan in second, Russia in third, Azerbaijan in four, Mexico in five, and Poland, of course, in sixth spot.